So today I'm going to show you the easiest way to delete your Google My Business listing. There's been an update that makes it even easier to do so. But also there's been confusion because sometimes you go to delete it, but it's still there in Google Maps, or it still shows when you do a search for it in Google search engine. So I'm going to show you how that can be dealt with, the quickest way to fix that. And also I'm going to do an experiment to see how can I delete a pretend business I put up a few months ago and bring it down. I'm going to monitor to see how long it takes, one, to see if it disappears, and two, to see if it totally disappears out of Google My Business. So you're going to enjoy this video, and I'm now going to jump straight in and show you how to first of all delete it. So the other day I set up this business, Caesar's Fine Dine Restaurant, but quite remarkably I've had 16,000 inquiries. This is just a case of just adding a few images, just adding a few things, but I'm getting inquiries to a business that doesn't even exist. But you'll notice anyway, we've got lots and lots of people searching for this. If I do a search for the business, Caesar's Fine Dine Restaurant, it comes up there as a knowledge panel. But as you'll notice, apart from one post, that's all I've done. I've not added phone numbers, I've not added business hours. All I've got is just a fake phone number and an address. If I go to Google Maps and do a search for fine dine restaurants in the Bournemouth area, you'll see again it comes up and it's showing there, which is one of the reasons why it's getting a lot of traffic, because it's coming up in the top 20. So this is a case where I'm going to monitor to see how long is it before this can totally disappear off maps and off the search engine. But I'm also going to show you how you can close it down straight away today. So all you do is you go to your business and you go into info, and then you turn to this section here, close this business on Google. You can mark this business as temporarily or permanently closed. You temporarily close it if you thought you might open up after a certain period of time in the future, but actually you want to just remove it. So if it's a case of you absolutely want to remove the listing, then let's do that. And that's what I'm going to do. So click on remove listing. And now let's just go through this. The associated business information will still appear on Google Maps search and elsewhere on Google. If your business is closed, then you should mark it as permanently closed first. And that's what you need to do, is you need to first of all go to mark as permanently closed. Mark this business as permanently closed. Permanently closed business will appear on Google with reduced visibility. You can choose to mark this business as open at any time. So it is fully reversible at the moment. I'm going to close the business. You can now still reopen this. It's now under review. And you could also, now I've permanently closed it, I can now remove it. Let's do that. The associated business information will still appear on Google Maps. Yeah, we know that. You should mark it as permanently closed. We've done that. You'll not be able to recover this listing data if you change your mind. Well, obviously that's the risk that you're taking if you do this. You can transfer ownership instead. So it could be you're selling your business, or you want to move it, so you want to transfer the ownership across. If you remove this listing from your account, all of its content will be deleted, other managers won't be able to access it, associated AdWords Express will become inactive, any website published using this will then be unpublished. I'm going to remove it. And now if I look here on my list of businesses, it does no longer exist. Now there is another way, you can just click that, and you can then do an action and you can permanently close, and you can do it that way or remove a business that way. So there's two ways to do it, but we won't be doing that on that business. So if I look for my business now, it no longer is available to me there. What happens if I go to the Google My Business search, Caesar's Fine Dine Restaurant? Let me now refresh this. And at the moment it says permanently closed. And you notice now it's much more restricted of what you can see. But own this business, so I could still go in there and see if I can resurrect it. But over time, Google will remove this. Now I'm going to monitor this, and on a future video, I'll show you how long it took. So I'm marking today. Today is 17th of July, 2021. Let's see how long that takes. And let's go to the restaurant. So we notice it's here at the moment. If we zoom in a bit, if I do a search, if I look through these results now, so it's still showing there, permanently closed. If I click on this, permanently closed. So it is still there, still showing there, but no information, see if I hover over these, and now it's kind of disappeared. So we can see it's kind of half-heartedly disappearing. Now there is a suggestion, just one other thing you could do, is if you wanted to, when you did have access to it, you could have changed the address, you could have given it a totally new address. So at least then, and you could even change the name. So this is a suggestion on another YouTuber that you could change the name altogether, call it kind of Fred's Tires, give it a totally weird address, and you change the number so it doesn't exist as well. You could actually make all the things you could edit before you permanently closed it, you could have made it so that it just, no one's going to find it then at all. So a few questions have just been left now. How long is it going to be before it totally disappears? Is there a way of starting again, maybe having a better setup for your business? Or maybe you've had a duplicate and that was just deleting your duplicate. How can you now really optimize your true business? Well, I'm going to have very soon a 30-day challenge for you. And on that 30-day challenge, hopefully, if it's then available, so it's not available quite yet, but I'm going to be starting it in the next few weeks. When it's available, then you'll have the video here to look at. But meanwhile, if you want to know how we got on deleting that and how long we had to wait, then there'll be a video here too, and I'll see you there.